How you going, team? Time is 10 o'clock. We're up on the Holden Range, sort of, that area. It's night time. In the back I've got Jonty and I've got Smash. In the front I've got Kaze. And we're doing a bit of spotlighting. We're gonna shoot something, aren't we, Kaze?
Yeah.
We've got the 2-4, what's that, bud?
Hopefully.
We've got 2-4-3. We actually, last time we had a go at shooting, we were with Maori Television and we lined up a nice deer. Poor Kaze, what happened, Kaz?
The Maori Television, they had their sound crew and their microphone thing was waving in the air. So the deer saw it and got scared off. Yeah.
But you know, those guys got a job to do and it's pretty hard, the logistics of doing both. So we're just out by ourselves now to have another crack at it. So see how we go. I'd love to get some venison, would you?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. I'd love to get some. A few steaks for the barbecue for the summer. Bloody good. See how we go. Kaze's going for the shot. It's coming down, Kaze. Let it come down, let it come down. It's coming towards us. It's coming towards us. Watch out.
Meh.
Watch out for that aerial, Kaze. You're going straight in front of that aerial. Look at that aerial.
Meh.
Yeah, there's a shot there. There's the shot. Take the shot. No, it's gonna go. It's coming down. Okay, wait.
Meh.
Okay, change your position. Come up to the bonnet. Come up, bonnet. Come up, quiet. Don't knock the truck. Come up. There goes. There's the shot there. There's the shot. Quick. Hurry up, Kaze. Come on. There's the shot. Get yourself in position. Hurry up. Come on, hurry up, Kaze.
Meh.
Yeah, it's stopping you. Wait. Meh. You're gonna lose it. Yeah, there's the shot. Go.
Oh,
beautiful.
Gosh, Kaze,
you got it. You ace it. Go, Kaze. Go, Kaze. Go.
Yes, Kaze. Good stuff, man.
No, it's still going. Reload.
Come around the back of the truck.
Come on, Kaze. Hurry up. It's going to go down. It's going to go down. Watch your life. What's loaded?
Point to the safe direction.
It's a safe direction.
Yes, Kaze.
It's down. You got it, boy. There it goes. It's down. It's down. Make your rifle safe. Make your rifle safe. It's down. Got a knife?
Yeah.
Okay. Hold that.
Yes,
hold
Kaze.
That. Take it. Okay. Kaze, good boy.
Good on you, bro.
Yeah, who's got a knife?
I've got one.
That's a bloody good result, fellas.
That's
spotlighting doesn't get much better than that.
Good job, Kaze.
Oh, nice going.
Oh, Kaze, man. Good venison.
Good boy. Well done. Well done, son. Your first deer. Put it there. Bloody cracker.
Good stuff, man. Good stuff.
Thank you.
There it is. Okay, when you cut its throat, Kaze. Oh, actually, we'll let... do you want to put some blood on your new knife there, Johns?
Yeah.
Actually,
Kaze could do it.
Jonty's your guide. Show him how to... Deal with the throat, mate, to take it out. It's just a long cut, Kaze.
Oh,
lay your rifle down, make sure it's safe. That was their first shot, Kaze.
In here.
It was a perfect shot, mate. Wasn't going anywhere. You smoked it.
And then you got him in here again somewhere. Oh, nice
you know,
work.
Nice work. Absolutely.
Worked out perfect.
Perfect. Yeah, it's a perfect
it
hunt.
Came straight towards us.
Yeah.
Oh, razor sharp.
Razor sharp?
Yep.
It's cunning like butter.
Yeah.
John's using his new Simon Walker knife and it's looking pretty good so far, nice and clean. Geez, you're only touching it, it cuts, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at that. Pretty sharp, eh? That's a really good result, fellas. It doesn't get much easier than that. We've had a pretty good night. How many pigs did we get in total?
Five.
Yeah.
Five pigs. And now Kaze gets his first deer. And you haven't even shot a goat yet, Kaze. And you shoot a deer.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got a pretty good guide there though, Kaze.
Yeah.
Good teamwork, lads. Good team. And it really was good teamwork. So who was on the spotlight?
Lockie.
Good job, mate. You did come off it a couple of times.
Yeah, when you opened the door got in the way.
Oh, okay, righto, mate.
This is in good nick too, isn't it?
He was sort of feeding as he came towards us.
Yeah. You gonna knock that throat out or?
Oh, yeah.
Probably be easy, wouldn't it? Just watch what's going on, Kaze, because you'll be doing it one day yourself.
Yeah. Cut so nicely, yeah.
Yeah, it cuts beautifully. It's going well. Mind you, Jonty knows what he's doing. He makes it look easy too. He's done a few. Just don't cut yourself, Jonty, because it's bloody sharp, that knife. See that, Kaze?
Yeah.
Take it all out, looks a lot easier. I think we're going to keep the internal organs on this animal. Yeah, just, do you know how to do it and leave the diaphragm in, Jonty, just the guts?
Yeah.
Good boy. If you're going to be doing goats, you'll be doing that anyway if you're doing them professionally, so.
Yeah. I haven't done it much with deer.
I love the way you're using this knife there, son. You're doing a bloody good job, mate. You've got it really down. It's not a bad field knife, is it, for working that sort of work as well?
No, it works very well.
Yeah,
it's a great knife.
Yeah. Nice and tidy work. Well, Jonty's nearly inside the whole deer. You're going to find out the condition of the heart.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, gee, yeah, no.
Look at that.
Lung shot?
Yeah.
Through both
double,
lungs?
Double lung.
Double lung.
He wasn't going anywhere.
He wasn't going anywhere.
What's the heart like?
We'll have a look.
Oh, Smash wants to know the heart. He's going to fight you for it there, Kaze. He'll be fighting you. Yeah, he'll be fighting to put on the barbecue. Doing an epic job there too, Jonts. That's the one, good boy. Oh, my battery's run out. Hey. Pull up, Kaze. Big pull. That's the one. Come past, Kaze. Oh, you blooded me truck boys.
It's made all on my legs as well.
Oh, mate. It's going to look like bloody a horror movie when we go into town. Well done, fellas. It's up there.
Bloody good work, Kaze.
Go clean yourself in the creek, boys.
Good stuff.
Good going.
Oh, well, you already have pig balls in your mouth, don't you?
Hey, Kaze, look at you, Kaze. Did they blood you? Oh, mate. Get down there and wash it all off, Kaze. You get that face a wash. Get that balls testicles off your face.
I'll do it when we get back.
Good boy. Nice pig. You alright to get that up there? Give me a hand there, Kaze, or someone. Nice going.
Thanks,
David. Oh, man, Jonts.
Earlier when I chucked it over, I chucked it. I went on to the other side.
Oh, yeah. That's the one. Can you get over there? Or? That's the one. I'm a bit tired, it's been a long 3-4 days now, I've been going full on, but these guys kind of got me amped up again. I'm a wee bit concerned about Jonty because he had a concussion a while ago and I just heard you smacked your head while you're in the scrub today again.
Yeah, it's alright though. Yeah.
You didn't tell me that, boy.
Nah, sure right.
Yeah, and you're limping, he's got a knee that's been giving him trouble for a while. Maybe it's growing pains, you don't remember hurting it?
Nah, I don't remember hurting it, nah.
No complaints, eh? No complaints by the boys, just doing an epic job. These young fellas are really outstanding on the hill. And I'm proud to hunt with you boys. You've done bloody good today. Good morning. Well, staying in a motel and hunting with a film crew is a different experience. The boys are in their room still asleep. I don't know what the guests are going to think when they see in the morning the bloody state of the back of my ute. Looks a wee bit bloody rough. Oh well, a reality check for those that eat meat. Anyway, yeah, it has been a different experience, but I've really enjoyed it and I've learned a lot. Dog tired because we didn't get to, well, it's 1:30, I got to sleep. I was up again at 5:30, so it's been out a lot. But I'm learning a lot and I'm really loving this experience. It's bloody awesome. So the boys are awake and it's a pie for breakfast and
a latte for
young Kaze, and I got my coffee going. Rightio, we'll hit the road, fellas. It's a new experience, just say, staying in a motel and you go hunting. Coffee, different world for us.
We lose Smash on this part of the journey. Thanks, bro. Put it there, man.
Thank you.
Did you have fun?
Yeah, great fun. Cheers, Guzzy.
Cheers.
Okay, mate. Well, say good day to Pete. Say good day to your mum for us. Well,
thank you for having me.
Oh, you're welcome, buddy.
Yeah.
A real pleasure.
Yep.
See you, mate. Bye. Such a good bastard Smash, isn't he, eh?
Yeah.
You can go in the front, Cuz, if you want now. So we're going to head on home now and knock the skin off this deer and this pig and maybe eat something. I smacked the hocks off this deer. I've got this block and tackle, which I've got off Karaka Products. And it's a real bloody good one because you can do it all with one man because it's got a lock. So we're going to lift it up a bit off the truck. And you can't, mate, don't smack my camera. I will lock it there and just drive forward, I think. Maybe there's this go. Just locks in like that. And you can leave it. In the old days, I used to be holding one and tying it around a tree or something with the other. This is just easy. So I'll drive forward and should be sweet as. How easy is that, eh? Too easy. Get a place where the sun's not going to get it, Cuzzy. So the other side of me is good, yep. A bit of fat on the steer, boy.
Yeah.
Good. One of the things I found with deer is you get a lot of hair in the mane.
Yeah.
Oh, it takes. It's a skinning knife, so it's got a drop tip on it.
Yeah.
It's curved. Different to a boning knife, which is that one there. Because he did two in the engine room, right beside each other, bang, bang, didn't go down, and then a third one has a spine. That's one that put it down the ground.
Yeah,
yeah, the old 243, the old 243 is not like the 308. If you'd smacked that in the same place with a 308 or a 7mm, bumper wouldn't have gone anywhere. So it's a wee bit like the 243 for deer. Great for head shots and neck shots if you know what you're doing. But that was a cracker, man. It's a real good one, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice and clean. There we go, Cuz. Knock the skin off your deer, boy. Looks alright, eh?
Yeah.
Your job is to start picking all the hair off, son.
Oh, he's just turned up with Nala. Hey, Nala. There you go, mate. Hey, Nala.
How are we going for time, Kaze?
10 to 12.
Yeah, 10 to 12, but how long is it taking me to whack the skin with this pick?
20 minutes.
No. 20 minutes?
Yeah.
A bit slow then, eh? We normally do them about half that. I must be tired. Catch it and cook it. Take it home, cut it up and hang it any way you like in the day or the night. Catching your wild pork is out of sight. Catch it and cook it. A dog or two catching meat for you. Dog and knife, it's a bloody good life. Catch it and cook it. Take it home, cook it up anyway. You can boil, you can fry, you can bake. Don't ask why, just catch it and cook it. How you getting on, Kaze?
Good.
In the fire ready, boy?
Yeah.
We'll see how this water's looking. Oh yeah, boiling nicely. Just gonna just put our fat in there. Back on. Just half like that for now, because our water crease is going to go in there. Back straps, my favourite part of any animal. I've whipped the fat off, so we're going to put that into the camp oven. Got two, so plenty of food. Got some ginger I've cut up fresh, some nice shallots, four of those in there. Some cracked chilli. I haven't actually done this before, but my mate Mark there said it's a good idea, so we're going to hoof that in, see what happens. Some peppers, we'll put those later on. And we've got some sesame oil and also some soy sauce. That's going to go in after the fact, after we've cooked, because this stuff will burn on the hot plate. And of course we're going to be cooking with my favourite extra virgin olive oil. Right on there. Oh, look at that. Oh mate, my favourite veggie. Is it a veggie? Oh, I don't know, someone tell me. Oh, look at that. Beautiful. Gonna give it a wee dab down. One of the things when you're picking the stuff too, folks, is to try not to get the stuff that's under the waterline, because it does have liver flukes. Liver flukes can make you sick. That's why I always pick the stuff on the top. That is beautiful. It was gifted to me by one of my subscribers on my YouTube channel, Mason Sparks. It's a shin knife and it's a beautiful knife. Probably getting to the stage now where I need to run over the stone again. Just cutting these medallions off and peeling them off the side. I haven't taken the back piece off, the silver. People often, like, you know, they'll
fillet it like a fish. I'm leaving it on this one and I'm going to take it off that one because I like to experiment with stuff and I don't mind a bit of chewing sometimes. It's nice to get the old chomping and chewing going, so I'm leaving that one on that one. I'm going to take it off the other one. I'll show you what's going to happen there. It's very basic. It's like almost filleting a fish. I've got some guests today too. I've got Kaze eating with me, but also got a bloke got the camera and a guy doing sound and a producer here, so I'm going to feed them too. You guys going to eat with me?
Cowboy, bro.
Cowboy. When you smell us on the hot plate, you'll be just chomping at the bit to have some. Right, there's the one with the silver on the back. This one I'm going to take it off. It's almost like filleting a fish, eh? You go under here like this. Down here like this here. What I don't like about this is you do sometimes lose a bit of that pork. But you know what we're going to do is we're going to throw our piece into the pot so any bits don't get wasted and they go with the... That's much better. See that off there? And this is going to go in the pot with our watercress so we won't waste any pork. I think that's pretty good. That's going to go in the pot. And we're going to medallion that up. So that's going to be our chewing and it's going to be our tender. Kazi's eating with me today. What do you reckon, son? You going to have the chewing or are you going to have the tender?
Tender.
Yeah. Well, Clay's missing a few teeth, so I was going to go for the tender. I might have to fight you for it. Look at that, eh? Well, the chickens know there's food happening. They're starting to come over now to try and get a bit. You've got to watch them because they'll jump up here and have a crack at it too, eh? They'll tear straight into it. Righto. Our meat is ready to go on there. Now, the fire's gone down, so it's perfect. We've got nice low embers. How I like to cook. Not a roaring fire, so it's not going to burn the hell out of my olive oil because you want to have like a low heat, not too hot for olive oil. So we're going to get straight into this now. I think I'm going to just roll things around a bit. First we'll do these ones here with a wee bit of this. It's ginger, fresh ginger. Just a little bit more. And also some cracked chilli. Just to give it a bit of heat. Now I've got pepper, but I'm going to put that on a wee bit later because pepper does burn. We're going to mix it up. I was going to actually put the onions on first and sort of saute them, but I'm just going to smash the whole lot on there because I reckon that'll work well. Natural sea salt with a wee bit of seaweed. I'm going to also smack it over that too now. Let's see if we get the desired sound. Oh yes, listen to that. Oh, I'm salivating. Mmm, oh, it's gonna be so good. Salt we sweated out on the hill, eh boys? Quite a bit, so we need to put plenty of salt back in there. Mmm. Oh, it's gonna taste so good. Oh, brothers and sisters, look at that. Oh, mate. Food of gods, look at it. I'm not gonna eat all that, no trouble. Actually, we've got guests, I'm being greedy. I'm being a pig. Come on, put some back, Clay. Stop being a pig. Eyes are bigger than the stomach. I've got guests. You can go like that. He puts like 1/8 of it back. Check it out, whānau. This doesn't come any better. Okay. Now, on top of that, we're going to add now our sesame oil. Just a little bit. Not to be silly. Just a wee bit. A little bit of soy sauce. Don't want to get too much, otherwise it gets too salty. There we go. That is just about ready, but our pepper is going on last. Didn't cook it with the pepper because pepper can burn sometimes. The pepper's just going to give us a little bit of heat. Oh, I'm loving this. Alright, that's one for you, Kaze. Telling the chicken to get away from this food. Anyway, from the hills of Blenheim here to Mapua, you worked hard for it, you ran after it, you killed it, you carried it out, now we feast on it. Tear into it, son. Oh, man. You know, that bloke, Mark, told me to put a bit of chilli in there. He knew what he was talking about. That heat is just really good. It actually complements the ginger. I almost feel like I'm eating in Thailand somewhere. Maybe that's also the sesame. That's good chomping and chewing, eh, boy?
Yeah,
man. He's good. Already eaten quite a bit of venison because he also shot a deer last night after eating pig honey.
Honest opinion, Mark, what do you reckon, honestly, bro? You got the chewy one.
Delicious, man.
Yep,
very yummy. Good one. Oi, thumbs up.
Riwi?
Right.
Smiles as well.
Reka, bro. Reka.
Leka. In Māori it's reka, yeah?
Yeah, reka.
Yeah, reka, okay.
Tino reka. Tino reka.
Okay, Kane likes it. You like it, Kane?
Can't get any better than this, bro.
You can't, bro.
Good, bro.
Yeah.
Good,
bro.
Skoumataka.
Thanks for joining us, folks. I hope you enjoyed the clip as much as I enjoyed making this one. It was a real cracker and a pleasure to have these guys on the hill. And I learned some stuff today, actually. I learned some stuff from Mark. Mark said, Clay, post more stuff.
I reckon you got Irish blood in you, yeah? He's got the mad humour, but he's actually one of those thinking guys. He had so much shit to carry around the hill. I was like, how's he gonna get up there? And you know what? He didn't get up there. He got left behind. But we've got some stuff on the GoPro in close for you guys. So really enjoyed making this one for Maori Television, the program Hunt With Me. I hope you enjoy watching. It's going to be on, well, it's already been on actually, because I have to post this after their one. But enjoy the show. We're having a lot of fun here. Good luck with your own hunting, your own gathering. Be good. If you can't be good, be careful. See you later.
Catch it and cook it. Take it home, cut it up and hang it any way you like in the day or the night. Catching your wild pork is out of sight. Catch it and cook it. A dog or two catching meat for you. Dog and knife, it's a bloody good life. Catch it and cook it. Take it home, cook it up any way. You can boil, you can fry, you can bake. Don't ask why, just catch it and cook it.
How you getting on, Kaze?
Good.
Getting the fire ready, boys?